It's always true that you can determine which molecule is a stronger acid or base if you have a table of pKa's. But there are times when it's useful to be able to look at the structure of a molecule and figure out just how good of an acid or base it's going to be. Okay, so in this video, what we're going to do is we're going to talk about a couple of ways where you can explore the structure of two different molecules and, based on their structural properties, predict which molecule will be a stronger acid or which will be a stronger base. Okay, so I'll start off by reminding you that when we talk about a stronger acid, what we're really talking about is a molecule that can more easily undergo the acid dissociation reaction. And when we're talking about a stronger base, we are talking about a molecule that can more readily undergo the base dissociation reaction that we see here. So if we can predict that, let's say, the products in a Ka reaction are more stable than the reactants, then we would predict this to be a pretty good acid, because if the products are more stable, that means we are more likely to favor products and create a higher concentration of hydronium. The same thing goes with the base dissociation reaction. If we have a reason to believe that, let's say, the reactants are more stable than the products, then we have a reason to believe that this molecule would not be as good of a base. So, in large, the really big guiding idea here is going to be resonance. Right, so hopefully you remember resonance structures from learning about Lewis structures. And what's important about these is that the more resonance you can draw, the more stable a molecule is. Okay, and the reason that's really important is when we're talking about acids, it's usually the base form of acids that have the ability to undergo resonance or be stabilized by resonance. So the more resonance structures you can draw of the base is going to mean that the molecule will be a pretty good acid. And here's a really great example. So if we consider, let's say, nitric acid. So nitric acid is NO3 minus, and we're going to compare it to nitrous acid, where the conjugate base is nitrite. Right, so we want to compare HNO3 to HNO2. Okay, and if we draw the Lewis structure of the bases, what we see here for nitric acid, or nitrate, the conjugate base. Okay, so this is the Lewis structure of nitrate, and this is the Lewis structure of nitrite. So for nitrate, we're able to draw two other resonance forms. Whereas nitrite, we can actually only draw one more. So we have two resonance forms for nitrite, but we have three resonance forms for nitrate. And since there are more resonance forms for nitrate, we would say that nitrate is more stable than nitrite. So nitrate is more stable than nitrite. So for nitric acid, the products are going to be favored more so than the products with nitrous acid, which is why nitric acid is a stronger acid than nitrous acid, because of the stability of the base, which we predict based on the number of resonance structures. Okay, so that's if you're dealing with resonance. And most questions about predicting which is the stronger acid will boil down to thinking about the conjugate base and think about which of them is more stable due to the number of resonance forms. There are a couple examples, though, where we can think about the stability of the reactants. And the one that jumps out at me right now is when you think about hydrofluoric acid versus hydrochloric acid. Okay, we've said before that hydrochloric acid is a strong acid, And hydrofluoric acid is the single halogen that creates a weak acid. So why is hydrofluoric acid weak when the rest of the halogens create strong acids? And the answer boils down to the stability of hydrofluoric acid in water. So when we think about the reaction that happens, HF reacts with water and we form fluoride and we form hydronium. Compare this to when HCl dissolves in water. So it reacts with water, we form chloride, and we form hydronium. Okay, so in this case, comparing products isn't especially useful. Fluoride and chloride both interact with water through ion dipole. There's no resonance to consider, so there's really no preferred stability of fluoride versus chloride. They're both ions. Okay, but there is something really important that we consider about the reactants. So when we think about the intermolecular forces that hydrofluoric acid can participate in versus hydrochloric acid, hydrofluoric acid can hydrogen bond. And this is really important because it can hydrogen bond with water. Hydrochloric acid cannot. So since hydrofluoric acid has the ability to hydrogen bond with water, then that inherently makes the reactants more stable. Hydrofluoric acid in its protonated form is more stable than hydrochloric acid because hydrofluoric acid will hydrogen bond with water, hydrochloric acid will not. So this is not a strong acid. Instead, it's an equilibrium because hydrofluoric acid is stable enough to be present in some cases. Okay, so these are the two things that you're thinking about. Think about the resonance stability of the bases and the types of intermolecular forces that the acids can have with water.